And now let's move on to our continuing focus on India's bid for gold at the upcoming Olympics tonight. Badminton superstar Saina Nehwal, who's recovering from a bad year on the courts in 2011, but is now on a red-hot streak after two back-to-back tournament wins.
I'm dreaming it every day. It's such a sweet memory, and it's such a, you know, a sweet dream. I really see myself standing on the podium every day.
All hopes pinned on one of India's best prospects at the Olympics. The 22-year-old poster girl of Indian sports seems unstoppable. In 2006, Saina Nehwal caught the world's attention after she beat the odds by becoming the first Indian to win the Philippines Open. That too despite entering the tournament seeded 84th.
Congratulations to India's Saina Nehwal!
After her performance at the 2008 Beijing Olympics, the 18-year-old was famous, the first Indian woman to get to a singles Olympic quarterfinal. In the next 4 years, she became a household name, clinching one Super Series title after another. Her strategy was simple: ignore rankings, focus on performance. 2010 was when all the hard work finally paid off. She pocketed 5 titles, but her moment of glory was the gold at the Commonwealth Games in Delhi. Her ranking touched a high of world number 2, but after the stunning high came the morale-breaking slump. Saina Nehwal battled injuries in 2011 even as she crashed out of several series, managing to clinch only one title in the entire year. But she soon bounced back and delivered with confidence. She became the first Indian singles player to reach the final of the BWF Super Series, after that successfully defending her Swiss title, ending her run-up to the Olympics on a good note, with two back-to-back title wins in Indonesia and Thailand, making the Chinese contingent's worst nightmare come true.
This is a great boost for me before the Olympics.
As she lifted the cup in Jakarta, the world number 5 lifted a billion hopes too. Will she break the Chinese supremacy this summer? Will she give India its first badminton medal?
Well, that's the big question confronting Saina Nehwal, who I spoke to earlier, and I began by asking her how she was handling the 5-week training. It's the last bit of fine-tuning that she's undergoing. So, how is that going?
Preparing well. 1 week has been good. Happy with the way I've played for like a week now. And more than that, the tournaments were very good. Really happy with the win these two tournaments, and I found some areas which were weak in these two tournaments, and we're working on those areas. And apart from that, really working on a lot of other aspects like weight training, endurance, and all the areas are important, because Olympics is a big tournament and you need to be very, very fit for the tournament. So I'm working on all areas.
Right, Saina, you're one of the few athletes who've also played in the Beijing Olympics. So any lessons that you've learned from Beijing, you'll carry to London with you, especially with regard to handling an event as big as the Olympics?
It is a big event, of course. I've played Beijing and did really well over there. Of course, it was my first tournament, so it was different. And it is the second one now, so there will be a lot of expectations and the pressure will be there. But I just want to do well. I hope I stay injury-free and be ready for the Olympics. And last 4 years, a lot of things have changed. I have won so many tournaments. I am in top 5 and I'm doing pretty good at the international level. So I hope, you know, everything goes well in Olympics.
Right, Saina, you're undoubtedly one of the best badminton players in the world, but an entire country's medal hopes are now resting on you and athletes like you, especially that you're having such a good run. Is it hard to deal with this kind of pressure? Or do you think you're used to it?
Yeah, I know, I understand that. People have a lot of expectations, but I just want to work hard. Finally, I can just train and do well in the Olympics. I can't predict whether I'm going to win or no, but I can just train hard and be ready for the Olympics.
Right, well, Saina, you back-to-back wins recently. What are you more pleased about? The fact that you won or the way you won? There were long matches, you almost were out in some of them, and yet you managed to come back.
Important thing was playing more matches, and I'm really happy that I played almost 10 matches in 2 weeks, and of course I won 2 tournaments, so I'm really happy about that. Played some fantastic matches against the Chinese players, really tough matches, really happy that I pulled out those tough matches, and yeah, mentally I was really good in these 2 tournaments, but I hope I remain the same way for the next 5 weeks and also play the same way in Olympics, but of course the atmosphere will be different, everything will be different in Olympics, there will be, you know, the stadium is different, the, you know, the place is different, so let's see how it goes there, but I'm really happy that I did well in these 2 tournaments with a lot of, you know, the training we did for 5 weeks really worked very well over there.
Right, but Saina, just about a year ago, things weren't quite the same for you. In fact, you said yourself it was a bit of a slump for you. How did you deal with it? Did you ever think that the London Olympics really seemed like further and further away?
Yeah, I think last year was, I couldn't win those tournaments, so people say it was a little low year. But I feel I played really well last year also. I played 4 finals, won 1 tournament, so it was pretty good year. Of course, I couldn't win those those tournaments, but I'm happy that I progressed really well and doing really well this year. Won 3 tournaments, you know, up to date, so I'm happy about it.
Right, Saina, so tell us, what is it that you've learned from your opponents?
I learned one important thing, that is never to give up. All the players are fighting till the last point, you know, now on, because I saw my quarterfinals match again on TV, and it was amazing to see the Chinese player fighting for each and every point. So every player is fighting for each and every point, and that's the main thing which I'm learning from all the players.
Right, Saina, we want to know, if you could watch 3 fellow Indian sports people compete in the London Olympics, who would they be?
Yeah, I think Mary Kom, she's I think in a great form. She's won 5 world championships, so she's going to be a great medal prospect. And of course, I think from badminton, I can say Jwala Ashwini. They did really well in that stadium last year, won bronze for India, so I'm sure they are going to do really well. And of course, in boxing, we have Vijender and Gagan Narang as well. In shooting, Abhinav Bindra. All of them are doing really well, so I can't name 3 names, but I think all of them have the potential to win medals in Olympics.
Right, so not willing to name those 3, but of course, nonetheless, you're naming your favourites as well that you'd like to see. Saina, before we let you go, any message for your fans before you head out to London?
I would just like to say, keep praying for me and keep supporting me, and yeah, I just hope I do well there and live up to everyone's expectations.